Let's speak to Mal Fletcher, who is such a commentator and a futurist as well. Good morning, Mal. Have you had a chance to look at this in detail? Because the trouble is, this is really, really, as we keep on saying, it's complex stuff, isn't it?
Yes, good morning, David. Good to speak to you again. Look, I'll be honest with you, I haven't had the time, and I think most of our listeners wouldn't have had time to read 580-odd pages in the full deal document. I'm a relatively astute follower of the news, most of the listeners would be. There's a lot of headlines at the moment about the to and fro between London and Brussels, about the internal struggles within Parliament here, but there isn't much explanation for the public of what this deal actually means for things like our ability to make trade deals, what it means to migration and legal independence, what it means to our standard of living in the medium to longer term. So I think we're relying on parliamentarians to actually do the deal, but everything's happening in a blur, as if we're in a race to a finish line and we don't have time to understand at least the big themes within the deal. And I think that makes many of us suspicious about the motives of the EU. And if the deal is signed in confusion, I think we'll end up trusting our political classes, sadly, even less than we do today. And I'm not advocating, by the way, necessarily a second full referendum.
So much of this reminds me, and this is a really crude analogy, but it's the best I can come up with at the moment, of when you're given a terms and agreements document with so many of these things we sign up to online, and whatever it is you're buying or you're about to sign up to, you want so badly, you just don't care. It gets to the point where I'll just sign it. Just where? Just I'll press accept. And there is that sense at the moment that almost we can't be bothered with sweating the small stuff anymore, which is dreadful, isn't it?
Yeah, it is in a way. I mean, the politics job is to present it to us, though, in a way that is accessible to us. So we don't have to dot every I and cross every T as members of the public, but we should at least be given something about the big themes. And I think many of us now are waiting for this forthcoming debate in the House of Commons, this so-called meaningful vote, to hear clear outlines of what's actually in the deal. Because we're not going, even if we read the 580 pages, we may not fully comprehend the implications of all of it anyway. So I think, yes, you're right. And look, with sign-ups online, let's remember what happens to us in the end of that process. We end up with Facebook compromising our data or somebody else, Google or somebody, you know, sharing our data in ways we hadn't thought we hadn't authorized. So that's never, that lethargy is never a good thing. But politics has to work harder to engage us in the process.
Thank you very much, Mal. Good to have your insights, as always.